smoke bombs, flares, being an attempt to come onto the field. Something falling on the smoke, falling onto the ground. The players, the New Zealand players, had to get out of the way of that missile falling on the.
And as you can see, they've now stationed themselves on the pitch. We imagine there must be 500 or 600 of them, and the police are now taking pretty firm measures to try and disperse them. We suspect that tear gas canisters have been thrown.
My name's Andrew Beyer, and I was a protester in the 1981 Springbok Tour. Those South African sporting teams not only represented that system, but they'd also become the focus of international opposition to apartheid. So an opposition to those sporting teams was an expression of opposition to the system of apartheid. We then set up a strategy to protest every time the Springboks played, wherever they played in Aotearoa, New Zealand. Our network of organisations throughout the country would protest in their places. And so that's really what happened, was that over those months there'd be protests all over New Zealand. This is the kind of ad we'd used to raise money and spend far too much of it on advertising the newspaper. But the effect of this ad and our other publicity, if you want to stop the tour, march tonight, is that we had the conservative media telling us there was 25,000 people marching in Queen Street. So that indicates to me not that we were communications geniuses, but there was a huge community of people who wanted to come out and express their view against apartheid and against the tour. It was an unusual circumstance in that Nelson Mandela came here for Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting. And my understanding that concluded one afternoon, and then the following day he then began a visit to New Zealand as the President of South Africa. And we got a message, I can't quite recall where it came from now, but we got a message that in that gap, Nelson Mandela would be available to meet with Auckland-based protesters against apartheid. What we have today in St Matthews is a visit from probably the greatest person in the world at the moment, and at the same time he seems like an old friend. Well, I was very fortunate to be able to meet him directly. He was a very peaceful man, a joyful man, and a man who had a kind of aura that conveyed those qualities and his values to others just by his very presence. I think beliefs, values, commitments, I think many of us, and perhaps most of us, have some things in our lives that really matter to us. And when we have something like treating other people with respect, when that's one of your commitments or one of your values or beliefs, we have to recognise we live in a world where that doesn't always happen. So in order to hold that belief, it becomes almost necessary to also stand up for it and to express it, and when necessary, take action. No,